Hey, I say craft, you say commerce, right? Craft?
Commerce.
Commerce. Wait, do you think, sorry, are you here for the money? Is that what you think this is about?
Yes.
So, hold on, we need to talk. My name is John Meese, and I have been attending Craft and Commerce since I was hashtag chilling in the front row. Do we have slides? Do you guys see the slides? Okay, there we go. Yeah, that's me. So there's me, hashtag chillin', in the front row at the first Craft and Commerce back in 2017, which requires serious commitment because there is no such thing as a direct flight to Boise. So, especially from Tennessee. Now, while I've been at Craft and Commerce every year, you might actually know me best from somewhere else, the ConvertKit landing page builder. Every single time you create a landing page, you see my face. Let's zoom in a little bit closer. Closer. There you go. Do you see it? Do you see it? That's me at Craft and Commerce in 2018. That's my claim to fame. That's me with Catherine Barry, Nathan Barry, and Nathan Barry's mom. Hey, Lynn. Now, this room is filled with incredible humans, incredible creators who are creating blogs, podcasts, newsletters, masterminds, memberships, courses, all designed to help people become healthier, wealthier, and happier. And I am so honored to be in this room with you, which is why I'm glad to come back every single time. Now, you're here to learn, you're here to grow, you're here to connect, but first, do you remember your first product launch? I want you to just think back, just take a little nostalgia with me for a minute. Do you remember the first time that you put a price on something and you said, hey world, you wanna buy this thing? I do. It was terrifying. The year was 2015, and some guy from Alabama had just earned over $200,000 in 2 weeks from selling an online course. How did I know that? Because he had the nerve, the audacity, to share all the details on the internet. And after I picked my jaw up off the floor, I realized and admitted that I wanted to learn more. So I did something radical. I asked Brian to meet me for lunch. Imagine my surprise when he said yes. So I met Brian at Corky's Barbecue in Nashville, and he grilled me, pun intended, thank you, on my entire course launch strategy. If you don't know Brian, you have to know this about him. He's incredibly intense. He's the kind of guy, and this is not a joke, this is what he actually did. He forces himself to donate $100 to a charity that he hates any time that he skips tracking a meal in his fitness app. So he takes that same intensity to digital marketing. And so I remember just hurriedly trying to eat this like corn on the cob, this greasy corn on the cob at Corky's while Brian's grilling me on my business strategy. And I'm like, sales page. I'm going to make a sales page. Pricing tiers, yes, three pricing tiers, just like you recommend. Email subscribers. Oh, you want to know how many email subscribers I have? Well, I was embarrassed. You see, I knew Brian's public advice. You can't launch an online course till you have at least 10,000 email subscribers. That's the only way you know it's not gonna work. But I answered honestly, 257. I only had 257 subscribers. And you know what's even worse? They were in a MailChimp account. I'm sorry, Nathan, it was 2015. Now, in my defense, ConvertKit only had 164 customers at the time, I checked. But I was not one of those 164, so maybe that's why I only had 257 email subscribers. So Brian stopped asking questions. He said, well, let me know how it goes. And I could tell he lost interest. So as far as Brian was concerned, my course launch was a flop. So I went home. I stared at my 257 email subscribers in a MailChimp account. And then I started reading off names from each of those email subscribers. Now, I knew my mom's name, of course, but there were other people on my email list, strangers from the internet, people who had signed up to learn from me, that wanted my help with something. So I thought about that, and as I read through these names, I realized that each one of these email subscribers was a real human being with hopes, dreams, and fears. I didn't just have an audience of 257 email subscribers. I had 257 real people who wanted my help. And so I remember closing my eyes and trying to imagine what a room full of 257 people who want to learn from me might look like. And actually, wait, how many people are here. Let's see. One, two, three. Don't worry. I'm not going to count everybody. There's about 300 people here. And look around you. Is this a tiny, insignificant audience? No. No. The answer is no. That's not a trick question. So this is an incredible crowd of incredible people with hopes, dreams, and fears. So I remember in that moment, I felt invigorated, that I was so excited that I could speak to an audience of 257 real people anytime I was brave enough to send an email. There are people who would commit serious felonies to be up here on the stage to talk to that many people. I committed no felonies to get here, just for the record. So I wrote down this little motto on the edge of my desk, actually, like literally wrote it on the desk. Relationships before results. And I made that my motto, just to try to remind myself that we are real people connecting to other real people through the magic of the internet. It doesn't matter how much money we make. It doesn't matter what kind of results you get if it costs you the trust of real people with hopes, dreams, and fears. So I started writing every email as if I was talking to just one person, right? I poured my heart into understanding their pain and their suffering and offering a path to help them feel better, to help them grow, to put relationships before results. I thought, okay, if I ask people to reply to my emails, if I talk to each subscriber individually as much as I could to answer their questions, then I would be putting relationships before results. Now, results first thinking says that with 257 email subscribers, my launch was a bust, right? Nothing I could do. But relationships first thinking says that every single email subscriber matters, that it's a real human being. Every single email subscriber is a real human being who wants your help. So relationships before results. I made that motto, I chose to live by it, even though I had a lot depending on my first product launch, because at the time, I worked at Chick-fil-A. That's me when I was 15 when I started working there, and that's me in my 20s when I still worked there. So I've been working at Chick-fil-A for a long time, and off and on since I was 15, but I still only made about $25,000 a year, and my wife was 30 weeks pregnant at the time with our first child. And so, you know, she was a school teacher working long days and nights to earn less than I did. And we both knew something had to change. So I took a risk. I launched my online course. And over 10 days, I earned $10,541.85 from 257 email subscribers. Thank you. Now, in 2015, for me, this was life-changing money. We now knew we were onto something, because remember, I made $25,000 a year, and then I made $10,000 in 10 days, right? So my wife and I had the confidence now for her to quit her job, focus on taking care of our children full-time. And then I wrote about that launch publicly. I wrote about it to report back to Brian first, but then he shared that immediately with his audience to highlight the success. And then the story spread, and before long, my story was being shared everywhere. 8 years ago, you couldn't listen to Pat Flynn, Ray Edwards, Michael Hyatt, or ConvertKit without seeing my name as a featured case study every single time. So I mean, this just was life-changing for me. So I thought more about it after I quit my job, and I realized, wow, I'm now all of a sudden able to grow my business while I grow my family. That's my oldest son, Damien. He's 8 now, but that's when I was baby wearing him right after he was born, writing a blog post. But I was just getting used to my new life as an entrepreneur and as a dad when I received another invite to another lunch meeting, this time at Bricktops, much nicer than Corky's. And I was meeting for lunch with a guy named Michael Hyatt, who is a New York Times best-selling author who wrote one of the most read blogs on the planet at that time. And Michael Hyatt was one of the pioneers of the creator economy long before we called it that. At the time, his company had just been ranked on the Inc. 5000 list of one of the fastest-growing companies in America. And so he invited me out to lunch. And I thought, okay, that's cool. I mean, I admired Michael, and I wanted to meet with him, but I wasn't really sure. I was a little confused why he wanted to meet for lunch with little old me. Now, at lunch, Michael thanked me for how active I'd been inside of his membership called Platform University, that I had been, he said, you know, you keep showing up and serving people and helping people with no expectation of anything in return. I said, well, of course. Remember the motto? Relationships before results. Then Michael Hyatt broke my brain. He asked me to take over Platform University. He said he wanted to focus on other projects, and he offered me a six-figure salary with a limitless bonus plan to run a multi-million dollar membership site with over 100,000 email subscribers who would hear from me every single week. Say, what? I said yes. And overnight, I went from running $10,000 launches to $500,000 launches with a full-time team of employees reporting to me. When I was on Michael Hyatt's leadership team, we hit the Inc. 5000 list of the fastest growing companies in the US again and again, 3 years in a row. I started getting recognized at coffee shops and or conferences by strangers who just wanted to ask me questions or take a selfie or shake my hand. This was life-changing. I started filling my phone contacts with best-selling authors, international influencers, and entrepreneurs running multi-million or sometimes billion-dollar companies all over the world. I was the dean of Platform University, a made-up title, but still, that's who I was, for 3 years until I helped Michael Hyatt sell that business 4 years ago. Now, that experience launched me into creating and selling two of my own businesses and ultimately to the life I enjoy now as a best-selling author and sold-out coach. I thought back to those two lunch meetings. I mean, each of those opened the door to incredible opportunity, and I realized something. It seems obvious now, but it was a total surprise to me at the time. Yes, whenever you put relationships before results, results come after relationships. I know it's obvious, but at the time, it was completely revolutionary to me that I now earn more every month than I used to earn in a year because I chose to put relationships before results. And it's not just me. Mike Pacchione, hey Mike, we got to know each other at Craft and Commerce over the last few years, and we became friends, and then he became a client, and last year, Mike Pacchione spoke right here on this very stage. Now, his talk was excellent, of course. He is a world-class speaking coach who helps every single Craft and Commerce speaker prepare for today. But before Mike took the stage, I asked him to make one little change to his talk. Now, results first thinking, right? You know what this is. Results first thinking says, put a really juicy call to action in there, right? Have some sort of compelling, you know, buy my thing, sign up for this. But Mike agreed to put relationships before results. He asked everyone in the audience to text him with his real-life cell phone number, a one-sentence description of Nathan Barry while he was up here on stage. Now, those texts started one-on-one human conversations with nearly 100 people from this audience. And then after connecting with those people with a few jokes and chit-chat, he invited many of them to a casual Q&A. After that Q&A, Mike sold out his group coaching program with that one Q&A. He didn't even get a chance to tell his email list that he was opening up a cohort in his group coaching program. Just from prioritizing relationships and following up, he sold out his group coaching program because Mike put relationships before results. Now, Sean Blanc, hey, Sean. I got to know Sean at Craft and Commerce just last year. Now, Sean is an OG creator. He's been blogging since long before it was cool. Not that I'm an authority on cool, but still, long time. Well done, Sean. Now, Sean's mostly well-known for his focus course, in part because he had a frustrating experience trying to sell premium programs like a mastermind or group coaching program to his 55,000 email subscribers. We became friends, he became a client, and we deleted every single high-ticket sales strategy that Sean had in his business. We simply sent a couple of one or two-sentence emails and with zero links to invite Sean's target client to reply, and then he offered to meet with them one-on-one for a serve call. Now, the serve call I'm teaching a workshop that goes into this in much more detail later today, but here's the gist of it. What most people do is they book sales calls with potential clients to sell a program. And sometimes it's cleverly described, disguised as a strategy session or discovery call, and it works, but it puts relationships before results and has a high failure rate. What we do instead is we invite target clients to one free coaching call using a serve call structure that, yes, often leads to a sale, but it's always to serve the other person. It's a high-impact coaching call. So they walk away going, wow, that was so valuable to me. And once Sean started giving serve calls, he earned six figures in 6 months from his new premium program, Focus Like a Boss. Now, that's extra revenue on top of Sean's already course and membership revenue and the rest of his business. Sean has now led three sold-out cohorts since Craft and Commerce last year. Despite his, I would say, massive audience of 55,000 email subscribers, Sean's success with his premium program came from simply talking to a handful of his subscribers one-on-one. This year, I brought a friend to Craft and Commerce, Dustin Reichman. Hey, Dustin. I met Dustin 2 years ago when he was a part-time traffic engineer with a couple of side hustles, and he had no real audience, but he started building relationships with podcast hosts and offering to share stories from his side hustles to inspire their audience, collecting relationships one at a time. He didn't have any products, but he used the same serve call strategy to get to know his target client one by one. He designed a premium program, and with their input, last year, Dustin earned $505,000 from 670 email subscribers. Well done, Dustin. That's nearly $1,000 per subscriber. Quick math, take your current subscriber count, add three zeros. Would you like to earn that? The answer is yes. So that was Dustin's first year full-time in this business, and he still doesn't have 1,000 email subscribers. He doesn't need to. March was Dustin's first $100,000 month. Dustin built a seven-figure business from scratch in less than 2 years because he put relationships before results. And the results came after. So I'm going to give you one super simple practical way that you can put relationships before results right here at this conference today. But first, I got to tell you where I got it. It's from Mike Kim. Now, Mike Kim is a best-selling author and sold-out coach. He's a marketing consultant now, but we met long before then, back when we were both members of Platform University, and we were both trying to learn how to blog, vlog, and plog. Sorry, podcast. That one never caught on for some reason. But Mike teaches that marketing isn't about closing a sale. It's about opening a relationship. Maybe now you can see why we're friends. So years ago, Mike taught me a super simple strategy that I've since used to earn hundreds of thousands of dollars from events like this. And I'm about to teach you now. Are you ready?
Yes.
Thank you. Take strategic selfies. That's it. That's the strategy. So you've already met many incredible people here at Craft and Commerce, and you're going to meet many more. When you meet someone, get to know them a bit by asking questions like, what are you working on right now? Just get to know them. But before you're done talking, pull out your phone and ask them, hey, can we take a selfie real quick? Let's go ahead and do it right now. Now, you start at, thank you. They brought the lights up. That's really smart. But I didn't think of that. So now you start a new text message, and you pull it up, and you say, okay, what's your contact information? Where's the best way for me to send this to you so we can stay connected? You send the message, and then after you do that, you've begun your relationship. Now, the reality is relationships they're not designed to end here at Craft and Commerce, right? You meet people, and you may need to continue that conversation to take that with you beyond today. In other words, take a strategic selfie, and immediately use that as a point of connection. Now, the other benefit for this is that when you're reaching out with that contact information, that also means later when you're looking back at your phone, you're not going like, oh, wait a minute, I knew I met so many cool people, but like, which one was Jeff? Sorry, who was Susie? Was Susie the one with that blog that I liked? Like that, wait a minute, was that Taylor Swift? Your connections here are connections with incredible human beings, creators, who are building masterminds, courses, memberships, podcasts, even though they're not called blogs, podcasts, vlogs, blogs, YouTube channels, newsletters. That relationship might turn into friendship. It might turn into a client, might turn into a collaborator, but it doesn't really matter because when you're putting relationships before results, that relationship always blossoms into something new and beautiful. I know many of you see yourself up here on the screen, and that's because I want to put you first. So I just want to encourage you to think for a minute. What if there was one person in this room who could change your life for the better? What if there was one relationship that starts today that changes your life or your business? Now, I know it can be hard to imagine walking up to some of the more inspirational people in the room, right? Some of the people that you think, man, they are out of my league. And I know how you feel because that's the exact same way I felt when I met my wife. Now, when I met her, I was a 13-year-old homeschooler whose hobby was chess club, and I was fresh off the high of winning the 8th grade spelling bee. So, I knew she was out of my league. She's smart, pretty, incredibly friendly and loving, and still, for some reason, she agreed to be my friend. We remained friends for 6 years, and then eventually I realized, wait a minute, who told me that she's out of my league? I was it. It was just me. Right? I was the one who was keeping myself stuck. As it turns out, you choose your own league. You choose your own league. And that means when you think about who you want to connect with this week, there's nothing standing between you and walking up to any one of the speakers, sponsors, or attendees of this event and just getting to know them and connecting by putting relationships before results. So I did that with Rachel. I asked her on a date. She said yes. 2 years later, I asked her on a second date. I'm still learning. Then I agreed, asked her to marry me. She said yes. We've been happily married for 10 years, and that relationship turned into other relationships. So now my life is overflowing with the joy of a wonderful wife and kids because I learned to level up and to choose my own league. Now, I had another lunch meeting recently, only this time was different. This time, I was the one giving a new entrepreneur advice and direction. I gave him the same advice that I'm giving you today. Put relationships before results, and the results will come after. Give yourself a human boost. Keep up the good work.